Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Being a Programmer. I am Rajashri and today we have to see manual testing interview questions and answers part 3rd. So part 4th, we already seen the part 3rd. Link of all the 3 parts are provided in the description box. If you haven't checked out, do check it out and then come back to this video. And for watching my channel, I really thank you so much. I want to appreciate you for watching these videos. And if you haven't subscribed, I have a little request to you to do subscribe to my channel. Also hit the bell icon, because whenever I update from my side any video on the YouTube, then you got the first notification from your side. And like to this video and let's begin with today's video. So for today's video, the first question will be how to identify the regression test cases and why need of regression testing. We already seen in previous video what is meant by regression. If you haven't checked out that, do check it out, because the link is provided in the description box. Because whenever you can see the regression, you know about regression, then you can learn about identify regression test cases and all that. So before this question, you have to refer what is meant by regression, what is meant by retesting, and all our questions are covered in the previous videos. So for today's video, there is a question: how to identify regression test cases. If you are a experienced person, then they will be asked to you how to identify regression test cases and why need of regression testing. So you have to answer this question very carefully. First, if the functionality, first of all, identify the regression test cases. We can see if the functionality X, suppose X is a functionality which is depends on the functionality Y, and with the change in functionality Y, if the functionality X is getting up related to functionality X, will be our regression test cases. Suppose consider here X is a functionality as well as Y is a functionality. So if your X functionality depends on Y, at that time, whenever if you change a particular particular change happening in the Y functionality, because X depends on Y, and if Y will be changed, then your functionality X also got affected. And if that will be happen at that type, your X will be regression test case. That means the affected functionality is known as a regression test case, or you can says that our regression test case, which will be the X, because X is affected due to Y, because X depends on Y and we can happening changes into Y. So X is a regression test case. I hope you understood. The functionality which will be affect is known as a regression test case. And sorry for the noise, because children are playing behind my house, so I'm sorry for that. Tolerate that. And let's continue with the video. Then the second point we can say here, and if functionality X and Y are interdependent, above case which will be different, X depends on Y, in that case Y will be changed, then your X got affected and X is affected, that's why we can say that will be regression test case. But if your X and Y are interdependent, that means X depends on Y and Y depends on X, at that time what happen? At that time, all the test cases are related to functionality X and Y will be our regression test case. If your X and Y functionalities are interdependent, means X depends on Y, if any changes happen on Y, then your X got affected, and Y depends on X, that means any changes happening in X, then your Y also got affected. At that time, all the functionalities related to X as well as all the test cases related to your functionality X as well as functionality Y, all the test cases are known as regression test cases. In this case, I hope you understood. There are two different test case scenarios. One scenario is that one test case depends on another, and second scenario, which will be both are interdependent. If both are interdependent, then you can choose both functionalities test cases as a regression test case. By using regression test cases, we will ensure that nothing has been affected either due to bug fix or any new enhancement. We already seen what is meant by regression testing. So regression testing means your test cases does not affect due to some big bug fixing or any new enhancement happening in your functionalities. Your test case does not affect. So this is known as regression test cases. I hope you understood. And this is all about this question's answer. I hope you understood this question. Then the second question will be, what is a regression? How will run all a regression suit if you have the less time? So this question also asked to experience as well as freshers, because in this question your motto will be your thinking, your opinion will be checked here. First of all, they ask you what is regression, and then there will be a related question asked to you, how will you run all regression suits if you have less time. So if you if they will be hired to you, and then you have less time, at that time what should you do for the regression suits? You will be run that regression suits or not? That question will be here. So here you they check your opinion. What your opinion? Are you able to work with them or not? So for this question you have to very careful. This is known as we all know, we already discussed what is meant by regression. So here is the definition of regression. Regression is known as set of test cases to ensure that nothing has been affected either due to bug fix or any new enhancement. If you your functionalities are got new enhancement or any big bug fixing are happening in the functionalities, then your test cases does not affect is known as regression. We already seen what is meant by regression. And our second question, how will you run all regression suit if you have less time? At that time you can say, if we have less time available, then we need to execute all the regression suit by setting late nights or coming over weekend to ensure that all the functionalities are working fine. We cannot take a risk of executing some test cases from the execution. So at that time you have to give the answer very carefully. You can tell them, if we have less time, then we can then also we can execute all the regression suits by sitting late nights. Also we can come for weekend and all the functionalities we check and ensure that all functionalities are working fine or not, because we cannot take a risk of executing some test cases and some are skipped from execution, because that will be happening some misleads to our functionalities and all of the about this answer you can say that. I hope you understood this question also. Then the second question, third question, what is dynamic testing? So this is the question, what is dynamic testing? And the answer of this question will be, it involve in the execution of code. It validates the output with the expected outcome. Dynamic testing means runtime testing, and you can say that it involves the execution of code, because runtime means you can execute the code, and at that time your actual output and expected outcome or output will be match or not, you can check in that, is known as dynamic testing. So dynamic testing validate the output with the expected outcome. That means some are our expectation from that functionality, and that functionality actual generate some output. So expectations and actual outcome will be match or not. So that validation involve in the dynamic testing. Then the another question will be, what is the static testing? So what is mean by static testing? So it involves in reviewing the document to identify the defect in early stage of SDLC. SDLC means software development life cycle. And in the software development life cycle's earlier stage, there are any defects, then you can identify through a document, is known as static testing. There is no execution of your code. It will be a test over a documentary part. So this is your static testing. And the last question of today's video, which will be the explain STLC. STLC, what is meant by STLC? So the full form of STLC, software testing life cycle. not a software development life cycle, it is software testing life cycle. So you have to explain software testing life cycle, and that STLC refers to all the activities performed during testing of software product. That means in this software you can test all the activities perform during testing of a software product. That means whenever you test a particular software, at that time what will be the activities happening, that all activities are referred into the software testing life cycle. So there are two common phases or most important phases in STLC, which will be first will be the requirement analysis and validation is the first phase of STLC. In this phase the requirement document are analyzed and validate the scope of testing is defined or not. So in requirement analysis and validation phase you can check the documentary part. Requirement documentation will be provided to the tester. At that time you can analyze and validate your scope of testing will be defined in that document or not. So you have to identify what will be the what you have to test, what is the requirement of client, and what about the project, all are the overthinking here. So you have to work according to that requirement document. So you have to analyze your scope of testing in the requirement analysis and validation. And then the second phase, which will be the test planning. So in this phase, test plan strategy is defined. Estimation of test effort is defined along with the automation strategy and tool selection is done. So in this phase, test plan strategy you have to define, and at that time you have to estimate some test efforts along with automation strategy, and you can select the tools. So that's all for today's video. I hope you understood all are the questions, and if this video is little bit helpful for you, please do like to this video, also share with your friends and family members, and sorry for the noise. Thank you so much for watching this video.